Good morning. Well, okay, it's actually like 3 o'clock, but that's okay. It's been a pretty busy day so far, and now we're cleaning out Ryan's car, and I thought I would start vlogging again because I'm wanting to get used to uploading stuff, because I also need to like kind of figure out how to edit things. If you can't tell from my last video, I have no idea what I'm doing, but that's okay. I'm learning. And so right now we're cleaning out his car, which is like right here. It looks clean because we just took out 3 entire bags full of stuff, and we need to like get out all of the trash and stuff that's in here and vacuum it and like wipe down the windows and everything before we leave in 9 days. And so we're starting that today, and I'm just gonna keep updating you guys as I keep going with my day. Okay. So I just got home. We finished cleaning out Ryan's car. It only took us like an hour and a half, which I'm pretty impressed with. Like, we cleaned everything out and wiped off like all the windows and all of like the hard shell stuff and vacuumed and everything. So that's all done. And then in about, what time is it? About an hour, I have to go pick up my pottery stuff. And then my friend who moved to Colorado just got back into town, or is driving back right now, and she's coming in tonight, and we're gonna go out to dinner, to ice cream or froyo, something like that. So it's much, much later in the day now. It's like, let's see, 11:37 at night. I went and met my friends for froyo with Isabel, and she's finally back, which is great. And I get to see her for 9 days until I leave, which is really exciting. And then after that, I came home and unloaded all my pottery, which is right back there. And I ended up coming out with like 20 something pieces, which I'm super happy about. So I'm gonna go over and show you guys what I made. Hello. So I am refilming this. I filmed it last night and uploaded it, and it turned out really bad. So we're just not gonna talk about that, and I'm just gonna do it again. So here we go. These are all of my latest pottery pieces, and I take a class, or I've taken a class a couple times, and the last class just ended, and they are like 8 weeks long or something like that. And this is what I made in that class. And I really like taking it. It's like a small group. There's only like 7 people or something like that. And so it's pretty individualized, and you kind of can do what you want. And then there's also like some more like teaching stuff, like demos and stuff. But anyways, here's what I made. Right here, I have all of my pots. And then I have my bowls and these citrus lemon juicers that I made. And right here I have my like cups. So I'm gonna start with all of the pots over here. So I think this one might be my favorite. It's a hand-built piece. And I just really like the way the glaze turned out on it. And I just think it turned out really cool with how the blue ended up dripping down into the dark brown. And I'm really glad the brown turned out like this. Sometimes it turns out more of a red color, but it turned out really dark and like chocolatey, and I really like it. And then I have a couple little ones right here. Here are all of the little ones that I made, and these are just going to be for little succulents. I started propagating them like a year or so ago, and so now they're all like ready to be transferred into actual pots. So I thought these would be like the perfect little size. They each have a little drainage hole in the bottom, and all of them were trimmed except for this one. I didn't have time for, but I still think it looks pretty cool. And this one I'm going to put on this little plate to kind of hide the untrimmed edge. And then we've three larger ones right here. This one I also didn't have time to trim. But again, I really like how this dark brown and blue ended up turning out. It's probably my favorite combination of everything that I made. Other than maybe this one, I really like how this turned out. Again, it's the dark brown. I ended up really liking it this time. My last class, I only dipped like one or two pieces in it, and I loved it. So this class, I was like, oh, I have to use it. And so we got this one, and then we've got this partially dipped one on the sides with this, I don't know what it's called. It's like a way of trimming that ends up with like a pattern. And so it looks really cool with this glaze. Yeah, that's all my pots that I made. And there's 9 little pots. So my room is going to be soon very decorated with these, and I'm really excited. And the next, yeah, I'll talk about these ones. I use a lot of lemons, and I really don't like squeezing them. It's like, I don't know why. I just really don't like it. And so we have like a little plastic lemon squeeze juicer thing, and I thought about maybe making one out of clay, so I decided to try it. And it was really easy for me to do. And so I made this one first, and this one I used it this morning, so it's like still wet. This one I made first, and I did the edges like just straight up and down. And when I was glazing this one, I actually dropped it so the inside is like two different colors, but I think it turned out pretty cool anyways. And then this one I did with like a swirl pattern on the edges, because I wasn't sure which one was like gonna work better, so I figured I'd just do both. And I used it this morning, and it works great. I absolutely love it. And then I have this little salt or pepper shaker I made. We had a little exercise where we made a bird, where we just like hand built it, and I was like, I have no reason to have a bird sitting on my shelf. So I, after hollowing it out, I just rounded off the edge as best as I could, and then put holes in the top so it can be a little salt or pepper shaker, and I think it's super cute. And then bowls next, yeah. So I eat everything out of bowls. If you cannot tell, I did not make a single plate. I just do not eat off of plates very often. I prefer bowls. I don't really know why, but I think just like all of the foods I either eat out of a bowl or a cup. And so I really wanted to make a bowl that I could like actually eat out of. All of my bowls in the past have been like really small and like more closer to like one of these sizes, so not really very practical for making anything, or to like eating anything in it. So these I was able to actually get stuff that was like a size that you could eat out of, which I'm super excited about. So talk about these three first. So when I'm throwing, I like usually end up throwing pieces that are similar if I throw them back to back. I don't really mean to do that, but it just kind of ends up that way. And so these three ended up very similar, and I actually like trimmed them all the same way, totally on accident. And when I noticed that they're all the same, I was super excited. So when I was trimming this one, I put it on the wheel, you know, to trim it. I had the clay pieces on the sides, and it came loose, and it just went flying off, and this part ended up totally breaking off. And so I just carved it out, and so it's a little like spoon holder, which I think worked out really well. I think in the future, I wish I would have done two of them. I could have put like a chopstick holder in there, but it's just one for this time, and that's all right. So I got those three little ones right here. And then I feel like these three are also pretty similar in their shape. And one thing I'm really excited about is that this class I was really able to start pulling up the walls evenly. And I'm just like really excited about it. I have not been like, I didn't really I don't really ever notice like very much improvement from class to class, but this last time, which I've taken it 3 times, this is the 3rd time, like the first day when we sat down, I was just like, oh, this is so easy. Why am I doing so much better than I used to do? I don't know what changed. But I was just like able to remember how to do things, and I'm just like really excited about everything that I've made, including all of my bowls. I'm just really excited about the bowls, honestly. And I'm gonna be eating everything out of these, and I'm gonna be taking some of them on my trip across the country and that I leave for in like 8 days. So yeah, here's these, and this one I think is my favorite way that I glazed it. Again, the dark brown and the teal blue is definitely my favorite one that I did this round. And then here is probably my like biggest accomplishment for this class. It's a bowl that I for sure would be able to eat like an actual like meal out of. Like I could put curry in here or cereal or soup, and I would have like a full-sized meal in this. It looks, I'm assuming it probably looks really small on camera, but just to kind of show like comparison, let's see if I can do this. It's much, much bigger, and I'm just really excited. And I didn't really, like I was able to trim it the way I wanted and pull up the sides like pretty evenly for the most part. And I'm just really excited about using this one. So next we move on to cups. Oh, and I have 7 bowls, which I'm really excited about the bowls. And so next I have my cups. And I have 6 of these. And so 2 of them I have no handles on. This one is really small. I think I originally intended it as a pot, but I forgot to put a hole in it. But I feel like this would be a cute little like espresso cup, or maybe for like a little snack or something, or like pudding or ice cream. Just a little guy, and I really like the way it turned out. I feel like it looks like an egg almost, like just the way it's curved. But I really like this one. And I've got this little guy that I was going to put a handle on, but I decided against it last minute for partially because I was out of time, and also because I feel like the shape of this just really like suits it without a handle. And I'm gonna use this for like a little chai cup, I think. And then this one is a hand built mug, or slab built. It's where you like roll out the clay and then piece it together. And it's a little one. And then got this one, which matches. This one's really similar to what I was doing my last class. Sorry, there's a plane going by and the dogs are not happy about it. And so this is like the style I went with my last class. I think mostly it's pretty small, but I do really like the way this little handle is. It's like a little ear. I really like it. And then these, my favorite piece, I think, might be this one, or one of my lemon things. I just really, really, really love the glaze. Again, I probably said this a gazillion times, but I'm just so happy with it. And this one's like the perfect size, and I can hold it great, and the handle isn't crooked or anything. And I just love it so much, and I trimmed it, and I'm just really happy about it. And we got a little matching set, a little like baby and a mom cup. So cute. And yeah, that's all of what I made this past class. The class was like once a week for 2.5 hours, and it was great. It was for 2 months, and I feel like I really learned a lot this class, and I'm just really excited for everything that I made and to start using this stuff on my road trip across the country, and I'm really happy. Okay, bye.